Both Randy and Leona are people who, like a lot of great artists, they maintain that playful capacity to keep doing new things. And that's what makes them both interesting, and that's why I think they're both going to get something cool out of the trip.
It's exciting.
We're going to see them bring new stuff into their work. They're going to meet people they never would have met. I'm excited because I think we're going to be able to get one more look at what kind of conference or convention or thing we could do in Alberta. I'm excited about what it could mean for what we're doing at the center and how we could become part of an international conversation about how this stuff works. It feels like everybody works in their own little bubble, their own little pocket, and it's finally there's enough of those little pockets that it's possible to start talking together and coming together. I think we got it. We get that up, put that little badger in there.
And then secure everything so it doesn't
move. Level and straighten and...
Oh, and labels.
Pin and label.
So far, it's really exciting. It's so exciting. There's a really fantastic energy.
Hello.
What are you drawing?
Horse, hopefully.
A horse. Where are you from, Leona?
Edmonton, Alberta.
Canada.
Canada.
What do you think of Glasgow? You like it?
Yeah, I like it.
Good.
You can do anything here.
Yes. Do you like the studio?
Yes, I do.
It's nice, isn't it?
Everybody's doing their own thing.
It's quite an honor to be here. Just a chance to meet people, view the sights of Glasgow, and talking with everyone, sharing their experiences. It's just like nothing else I've witnessed before.
I come from Ireland, and I'm a KK artist. I just drawing picture of Glasgow the way I see it, my impression. It's a very wonderful thing to do because I think it's very important for people with learning disabilities or artists to meet other artists who have the same sort of thing, And I think that is the most important. Meeting each other, seeing how they work, but then they might say, I like his work and I want to try to copy it.
Can you see it dripping?
Yeah.
It's like a little tap. Sort of dripping.
I see the little tap there.
Yeah. So what you do is, you have to move quite quickly, but you can draw lines.
I don't want that to be too full.
Better.
What are you doing there?
I'm just about to do an etching, so I'm just drawing it out. This is an idea I've had, so I'm just trying to see if it works. I've never done it before.
has that been part of the experience as you're getting the chance to do different things?
Yeah, I've got ideas of doing something similar at home, but I'm thinking about doing it with tinfoil on a piece of board, but then putting a bit of paint on it, but then putting it on my scanner at home, so you can get the similar effect of putting it through hopefully get a similar effect of putting it through the press, because I obviously haven't got one at home, but it's quite a good way of doing multiples of drawing of pictures.
What's your inspiration for your subject?
I just like changing places at the moment. It's like my pictures are upstairs, so I've decided to try and work on with the drawings I got upstairs and see what they look like if I just do them like this.
Just got the link for your finished movie. Do you want to watch it? You want to see it? We should try to show it later. Yeah. Or I'll get it onto my iPad at least.
Oh, this is dangerous.
This is Randy's movie. He just, my colleague just finished doing credits and stuff and sent it to me.
Excellent.
I love that part. Wait till you see what happens next.
Oh, dann kannst du dich kurz nochmal vorstellen? Kurze Pause.
Ich bin der Roland. Ich komme aus Mariaberg bei Gammerdingen. Also da ist Gammerdingen 2. Ich bin jetzt auch in Ruhestand.
His name is Roland Kappel. He's coming from Gammertingen, from Mariaberg, a small town in southern Germany. Mm-hmm. And he's now 65 years old and he quit working in the factory, so he's an artist full-time. The drawing is the King's Gate down here in Glasgow, just across the street.
What I like about these assisted or supported studios is that there is less of an emphasis on disability and more of an emphasis on the person just as an artist. And it seems to me that all the studios try and put that across to an audience first and foremost. That's the way forward, is to just get the artwork to sit alongside other artworks in the contemporary art environment. The collaboration then just involves a wider audience, and so you just kind of, the domino effect of that is, I think, really important. Yeah, I think it's important to have a differentiation on some level, because I think it's worthwhile, you know, looking at this work in its own kind of context. But at the same time, it's really important for it to just be part of the, you know, the grand pantheon of art as well.
Try with that. I mean, I can get thick paint too. We can do that as well. But try that. Ooh, now that's nice. It's turquoise now.
It's nice.
Yeah,
really?
Yeah, it's nice. It is. It's really vibrant. That white's kind of brought it alive.
Yeah. What I did, we ironed it. Ironed this, you know. And the clouds are kind of light blue and dark blue and light blue and dark blue. That's what I like about it. And there's white in there too. And I've tried to make clouds like that before. Now I know how to do it.
I'm Tanya Raber Weber, and I'm the artist in residence with Projectability and the Summit. And I'm doing a project called Summit Portrayed, where I'm milling about and creating a portrait panoramic, which will sort of tell the narrative of the 3 days.
This has been a long time planning. There was a huge amount of thinking went into just what it should look like, how it should, what the feel of it should be, what the ambition of it was. And there was a lot of reflecting on other types of events that we'd been to and then sort of deconstructing them and then building it back up again. And we actually arrived at a really simple format. It was so simple. It was to get a bunch of people together, like-minded people together, put them in a room for 3 days, lock the door and see what happens. And it was brilliant. So yeah, I don't see fireworks coming out of this, but I do see definitely strengthened connections. And that's always to the good.
If we don't find a t-shirt with a castle, we'll make one.
No.
Okay.
Okay.
Smile. That's better. So, do you think you'd like to draw this one? Should take a few pictures so you can draw from them later. Do you have a camera on you?
No.
Okay, I'll take some for you.
We're here, Leona. Let me give you your camera.
Okay.
Okay, Randy, hi. Awesome.
A little smile, Randy.
That was a fabulous picture.
Last one.
The picture.
Are you happy now you've got your t-shirt? Fantastic. Woo.
I hear them too. Where are they, I wonder?
Let's go take a tour, Becca.
I don't think we have time, but we can get up nice and close and take a few shots. Now point up though. That's it. You like the big Scotsman? That looks like a Scottish painting to you, right?
Yeah. Look at this one, guy.
I think this place is marvelous compared to ours.
It's a nice gallery.
You can't see the brush at all.
I like this.
Mr. Stennis, are you ready? Hey, is that Edinburgh Castle?
Yep.
On the hill? Cool. So should we go flip through and pick out some pictures to photocopy? And
yeah, sure.
Are these going to be part of a movie or are they more just for fun?
I make a movie about that, I suppose.
From the moment we left Glasgow, like the second we got on the plane, we started to see what Randy was doing because he just started drawing. And he's still drawing about Scotland. And right now he's finishing up a movie that really reflects a lot of the visual memories he has of Scotland.
Leona, these are all the pictures. We're gonna find a couple where you're working on something so you can remember exactly what you did while you were there.
Even 2-3 days in. the memories of Scotland were starting to fade for Leona. When you watch footage of her there, she's really engaged and having a great time, but couldn't remember. And that's unfortunately all of her life. But then it started to emerge, not directly, not as sort of obviously as Randy's work, but just sort of this landscape of rivers and rocks and all this, you know, Highland kind of visual material started to come out in this embroidery work that she was doing. And she developed a really beautiful body of work that has some visual reference to that experience of being in Scotland. You know, what we got from Glasgow was this chance to get this feeling that there's this community. And there's this chance to build an international association or, you know, coherent group that shares resources and challenges just by virtue of getting together how we do our thing. So the next step is to get lots of that to happen. You know, people coming, yes, they'd want to show off their center and stuff, but then to get deeper, right? What's the philosophy? What's the real mission? What does your center actually do for people? How do you think about it in that deeper way? You know, when I talk about why nine is important, it's not because it's fun. It's because it's profound. There's something potentially really meaningful that could happen here, right? This group of people who've never been allowed to say to all of us what it means to be a person could be doing that. So that's really exciting. How do we get there? I don't know if there is an answer, but something like a conference in Banff would be a great next step for thinking about how we do things.